Hey friends, Azure App Service offers more than 60 troubleshooting tools for diagnosing different types of issues, but where do you start? Now you can ask Microsoft Copilot for Azure about the problem you're experiencing and you'll get diagnostics and help resolving your issue. Hanna Endrias is here to show me how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Hanna from the Azure Developer Experience team, and we've got a really cool exclusive right now. At the time of the recording of this video, Azure Copilot Experience was actually in public preview. It's a limited preview. So if you go ahead and share your screen, there's an AKA link that folks can visit. We'll have it in the show notes as well. You can sign up and you can request access to Microsoft Copilot for Azure. Hanna, this is pretty cool stuff. So we've got you set up with to show us an inside preview of this Copilot for Azure.
Yeah, I'm really excited to talk about it. I think one way to take advantage of Azure Copilot is to use it to actually troubleshoot and solve your issues. So I'll show you how that might actually look like. First, let's show you an unhealthy resource. We can see here that my resource is unhealthy as it's experiencing an internal server error. And, you know, if you're a power user, you might actually be aware that we have built-in diagnostics located in the Diagnose and Solve blade right here on the left. Mm-hmm. These are diagnostics that our team has worked really hard to curate and has kind of organized in very specific ways. So we have them under these tiles. And if you click on it, then it can help you figure out which, you know, problem areas to investigate. So this is definitely one approach, one valuable approach to take to troubleshooting your issues. And obviously, we will still recommend it, but with the Azure Copilot experience, it's located at the top over here. What you can actually do is type in your problem. So in my scenario, I can say my web app is down, right? It'll take a minute to process, you know, what I've provided it and actually direct us to the appropriate diagnostics tool. And so, like Scott had mentioned earlier, we have more than 60 tools, diagnostic pages that you could explore. So instead of exploring, you know, every single branch, this kind of directs you to the right tooling.
And does it look at, like, what kind of things does it know? Because, like, I might have dozens of sites. And, you know, in that case, it's recommending a tool for you. But does it know what blade you're on? And how much context does it have about what's currently happening?
Yeah, so to actually get to this experience, I'm going to open up the Web App Down tool, which is the appropriate tool for this scenario. If you happen to be in the overview page, it'll ask you what resource you want to investigate. Certain Copilot experiences are blade specific, this one can you can open up from anywhere pretty much.
Cool. Yeah. So this one got you directly in there.
Right. So I didn't have to check all of the other wonderful tools that we've built. I've actually gotten to the one related to my web app being down. And I'll kind of break down how we go about designing our troubleshooting experiences. We try to be very thoughtful about the visualization and the information that's presented to you. So to even just get started with this graph here, you can actually notice that what it's saying is that Azure is pretty healthy, the platform itself. But our resource has actually been going up and down in regards to its availability. So we definitely need to take a look at it. The other piece of how we're structuring these pages is that we try to surface the most important troubleshooting information at the top. So we'll have it organized in the observations and solutions. These issues will often be expanded, whereas these other 17 healthy troubleshooting avenues will be collapsed and at the bottom. So, you know, traditionally without this information, you might have to investigate all these other 17 relevant troubleshooting avenues, but now with this tool, you're actually able to just focus on the top five. So that's what makes it, that's what makes taking advantage of Diagnose and Solve really powerful.
Yeah. You know, one of the things that I think is cool is that, and this is my opinion speaking, not as a Microsoft person, but just as a person that uses Azure, is that there's a lot of really awesome stuff that's kind of in the portal that maybe people aren't aware of. Right. And you have to know that they exist, right? So there's 60 plus different diagnostic tools. And, you know, you could search for them. You can go and Google with Bing for stuff. But or you could dig around in the UI. But in this case here, you got the right diagnostic tool because you use natural language within the Microsoft Copilot experience. And then it surfaced stuff that you may not have already known. Like, you may not have known this existed.
Right.
Right? But exactly. You don't want to bury your tools. You want them to be upfront. It got you the right tool at the right moment for the right job, which I think is really cool.
Yeah. You've really captured, you know, what we're trying to do with our Azure Copilot experience. So I'll dive right into it. You know, we have a website to get up and running again. So if I take a look at just this first error, the HTTP server errors, I can see that it's saying that there's something wrong with my application code or the platform serving the requests. And it's saying that maybe I should take a look at our web.config for this application. So in order to access that, I will go back to the overview page for my resource. And just go back here. And I can actually type in kudu.
This is a good secret trick. So kudu is a code name. So you got to the diagnostic advanced tools by using the classic code name kudu.
Yep. And with kudu, you're going to be able to essentially get to this page here. Mm-hmm. And from here, to get to my web.config file, I'll need to go to the debug consoles. There's a couple other tabs that you should definitely take some time to explore. But just for troubleshooting, I'll focus us where we need to go. We'll go to the sites, and then we'll go to www.root. Under here, I found the web.config file. So I'll just zoom in a little bit. Make sure you guys can see it.
Thank you.
We'll take a quick look at our web.config file and see if anything stands out to us. Oh, and then I noticed I actually did not close out my configuration tag. So let's try doing that, and let's go back up to save these changes.
Isn't that always the way? It's either XML or DNS.
Always something small. So let's try refreshing this page, and hopefully we'll get to see our puppy adoption website up and running.
Making a change to a web config causes a complete reset, a reboot of your application. So it takes a second, and there you go.
Here we are, getting to enjoy these cute little puppies. So our website is thankfully up and running. So this is one way you can actually use, you know, Azure Copilot to troubleshoot your problems today. Another way that you can take advantage of the Azure Copilot experience is by seeing what you could do to be proactive about your resources health. So I might type in best practices for my app. And so this is actually going to provide you with some of the diagnostic tools that we've and recommendations that we've kind of come up with over the years to keep your app running as healthy as possible.
Yeah, I think one of the cool things about this is that what is the difference, you know, between you know, searching the web for something and using a Copilot, and the difference is context. And because you're logged in and inside of the Azure portal, it knows things, and it knows things about the blade you're on. It knows things about your Azure account. So it's offering very specific, you know, diagnostic advice here. It didn't just search the web, right? It offered contextual advice here. So what is it suggesting we do?
Right. So it's saying here that there's some potential issues that could impact our availability and performance, which is actually something we were dealing with right now. This is the content in the text form. I'll just click opening up the risk assessment tab. But you can see here that it's saying we're not taking advantage of our auto heal experience. We're not utilizing our health check feature. We should consider distributing our web app across multiple instances. But it says we're actually doing a good job in regards to how many sites we have on this app service plan. So this is just a really quick summary, but you can actually do a deeper dive on these other areas where we think you could benefit from making these adjustments to your app service plan or to your resource itself.
I have never seen this part before. I thought I knew most of the diagnostic stuff for app service. Are these part of those 60 diagnostics tools?
Yeah, they're included in that as well, yeah. That's so we have a lot of recommendations, a lot of ways you can avoid, you know, hopefully heartache.
Puppy related heartache. If you don't mind, would you click on the view solutions on that health check feature one? Because like I said, I've never seen this before. And I thought I was very familiar. with how this stuff works. So it'll actually walk you through updating things, fixing things, enabling stuff. So it's gotten very prescriptive, and you're only two clicks away. Look at that. You're two clicks away from where you started in Copilot. Turning on a new feature.
Yeah, that's true. We really do try to bring, you know, our collective wisdom into this experience so that you don't have to, you know, redo the wheel.
And these diagnostics tools, they're being added, right? Like, I know that there's 60. It probably didn't come with 60. They've probably been added and improved. And some of them are contextual about what kind of app you have. It knows about your app. In this case, it knew that it's not distributed. It's just one instance of some one application.
Mm-hmm. Correct. Yeah. But yeah, you can definitely go through any of these, view the details, view the possible solutions to figure out how to make your app more healthy. But this is one of the ways that you can take advantage of Azure Copilot by being proactive. The other was to troubleshoot and solve your resource with Azure Copilot. With the Azure Copilot, we've integrated certain set of experiences for it. So right now you're actually able to ask questions about risk alerts, ways that you can be proactive, web app down, web app slow, high CPU, and event logs. And we're still in the process of mapping, you know, certain customer problems with diagnostics that we already have right now.
Yeah, when you say that you're in the process of mapping, what I hear is like it's just going to get smarter, and there's even more like stuff that's going to light up, because I'll ask it a question and it's going to, like you just showed me, tell me about tools I didn't know already existed. And those tools will contextually get me to the answer faster. Like, you were two clicks and now I've got advice, and two clicks, or one sentence and a click, and I got an answer and you fixed your website.
Yep, exactly. That's where we're trying to get to. Just making it easier to take advantage of the tools that we've already worked so hard on. Making it easier to find.
You know, there's a little historical kind of like joke that the Microsoft Word team told me once. And they said that they could pretend that there were no new features in Word and just tell people about awesome old features. And they would probably have like 10 years of like new versions of Word. But it's literally just showing them awesome stuff. And I feel like App Service, because you know I'm an App Service fan, has so many great tools, and like 60 diagnostics tools. People are always digging around in logs. And I'm like, no, use the diagnostics tools. So I think it's really cool that you're going to surface those great tools with the Copilot experience. And this is going to be hopefully, you know, rolling out to more and more people in the future, right?
Yeah, we really want more and more people to have access to this so that they, you know, take advantage of everything that we've all done.
That's cool. Let's go ahead and go back to that web page and see where folks can sign up. We're going to have a link in the show notes as well. This is something that is kind of going out, because at the time of this video, it's in preview, so you can go ahead and request access from that AKA MS link. And maybe if you're watching this video in the future, you already have this access and you can check it out. But you do have access, right, Hanna, to the diagnostics tools. So even if you don't have Copilot, go check out the diagnostics tools today, because those risk assessments, I didn't even know that existed. And where do I find that?
The risk assessment section is right here.
Very cool.
You'll click on this tile and then give it a minute to load. Mm-hmm. And then it'll show you all the other ways you can take
that. So you've got diagnostics tools, risk assessments that are all custom to your application. Mm-hmm. Love it. That's hot. Very cool. Well, thanks so much for hanging out with me today, Hanna. I appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
All right. I am learning all about the Microsoft Copilot experience and the underlying cool tools that I can use to diagnose and solve the problems with my applications today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.